Romper, stopper, bopper, boo. Romper, stopper, bopper, boo. Romper, stopper, bopper, boo.
Leo, what are you guys doing? What are you guys doing here?
Hey, Miss Marianne from Romper Room is going to be on tonight.
Yeah, I know Marianne's going to be on the show tonight. What are you guys doing?
We're hoping we should make us some doobies.
I'm pretty sure she'd make you guys doobies.
Awesome. She's not going to make us any bad doobies, is she?
I don't think there's any such thing as a bad doobie.
Awesome. Did you hear that, guys?
Yeah. Cool.
Yeah, you guys got way too much time in your hands. Jeez.
Does she have her own papers?
With DJ Leonardo Flores. I am your announcer, Tony Ridley. On tonight's show, former host of Romper Room, Miss Marianne King. Comedian, Mary Kennedy. The Funsters Square Dance Club. And rock band, Pretty in Stereo. And now, it's hip to be square, here's Marty!
Welcome to Marty's Corner as we come to you live, as always, from Channel 3 here in Hacienda Heights. How are y'all doing tonight? Get loud, come on! Yeah! Good audience tonight. We had a bad audience last show. They didn't get any of my jokes, so.
None at all.
Not a joke, huh? Not one, so I'm sure you're ready to laugh tonight. Hopefully I'm funny tonight. We haven't been with you for a month, and of course, a lot of things in the news since we last joined you. Media Watchdog Group plans to protest Carl's Jr.'s new ad feature featuring Paris Hilton. They feel the ad is going to be indecent. Have you seen this? Yeah. Carl's Jr. rep says that Miss Hilton fascinates Carl's Jr.'s most loyal customers, young, hungry guys. Yeah. What they forgot to add was young, horny, hungry guys. Is what they. Yeah. And also in the news, of course, a comedian, David Chappelle, is in the news. Apparently, Mr. Chappelle checked himself into a mental clinic last week. Did you see that? The comedian? Yeah. Too bad for him. He initially stated that he had an earache. Earache. Ear. Yeah. Ear. Yeah. Now, this is the same clinic, this exact same clinic that the actor Robert Downey Jr. checked into. Of course, Robert Downey Jr. is best known for putting the word meth in method acting. Bad joke. It's a bad joke. And speaking of drugs, apparently there's a new drug on the market that helps men delay their orgasms. And their partners report good sexual satisfaction, which is nice to hear. The only bad thing about that is apparently the men have to take 3 pills to satisfy their wives. So, 3 pills is what they have to take, Leo. 3 pills. Terrible, terrible, terrible. Let's flip this thing over. We're moving here. Speaking of that, also, apparently here in Hacienda Heights, a medical marijuana clinic will soon be opening here in Hacienda Heights. Did you hear about that? Apparently the second such clinic in Southern California. And, of course, we're just amazed that they actually... Leo, what are you doing? Leo?
I'm going to go to the clinic right here.
No, I don't think...
Where's it going
to
be at?
Well, I don't think it's that kind of a clinic. I think you have to have, like a disease or a problem that's going to help with the medical marijuana.
Well, it should be that kind of clinic.
No, it's not. In fact, let's ask Tony actually is taking nursing classes. Tony, what do you think about that? You think that'd be a... Tony?
Well, Marty, it's
Tony,
it's
I'm over
medical,
here. Tony, I'm
Marty,
over here. Tony.
Marty,
Marty,
yeah. it's for glaucoma, Marty.
Oh, okay, glaucoma is? Everyone on the show is a hophead. Okay, let's keep going. Cartoon and TV icon Gumby turned 50 years old last week. Did you see that? Now, at the large celebration in his honor, Gumby announced that he was gay and proud of it. Yep. This explains why he hangs around his friends Pokey, Prickle, and Goo. Yeah. And I'm happy to announce this afternoon that I signed a 2-year contract for $50,000 a show here at Channel 3. Huh? Yeah. $50,000. My only challenge now is to get the management to sign the same contract. It's all true. We have a good show for you here on Marty's Corner. 97th show, 97 shows here on Marty's Corner. One of our guests here tonight is a lady who actually is a resident here of Hacienda Heights, and she'll be coming on to talk a little bit about what's going on here July 4th in Hacienda Heights. Our good friend, the former host of Romper Room, Marianne King, is here tonight. Marianne King. A comedian joins us for the first time. This comedian actually plays all throughout Orange County. Again, she'll be making her first appearance here on Marty's Corner. Mary Kennedy is here tonight, live. Mary Kennedy live on the show. Do you like square dancing? Do you like to get out there in the square and dance? We have a group of dancers that have been nice enough to come down on a Saturday night to do some square dancing for us. The Funsters are here tonight. The Funsters. That's going to be bad. And you'll know what I mean later. And last but not least, a group of musicians have been nice enough to come down for their second appearance here on Marty's Corner. The one, the only, Pretty in Stereo is here tonight. Live on Marty's Corner. And of course, I couldn't do the show by myself. As always, to my right, the one, the only, Leonardo Flores. Leo. We have a fully packed show, so we want to start off and get things going right away here on a Saturday night. One of the things we did last month on the show was talk about something that we're doing on the internet. Of course, you can log on to Marty's Corner at www.martyscorner.com. And we're asking viewers around the world who are watching our show in real time on the internet, on our webcast, to take a picture of themselves and send it to us. And what we agreed to do is go ahead and show them on the air. So let's go ahead and take a picture of this our newest viewer here. We get a shot of this. This is Cory Clausen from Bellingham, Washington. If we get a shot of that Cory there, we can zoom in on that. There's a picture of Cory somewhere. We can get Cory there. Coming in on Cory. No Cory. There's Cory. In Bellingham, Washington. Again, his screen name is Nutnog, and he's watching us live from Bellingham, Washington. And now we'd like to go with Tony. Tony, could you go and put the dot on the map for Marty's Corner? All right, Tony, drum roll, please. To your right, Tony. Keep going. Warm. There you go, right. Get it. There it is, ladies and gentlemen. Cory Clausen, watching us tonight from Bellingham, Washington. Bellingham, Washington, best known for the place where the Hillside Stranger Kenneth Bianchi was captured. So a fun place to be. Thank you very much for watching us, Cory. Great picture, Cory, huh? Isn't that a great picture, Cory? And that's me right there. That's me. Hi, Cory. Our first guest here in Marty's Corner. Let me tell you, in about 3 months, we're actually going to be celebrating two anniversaries here in Marty's Corner. Our 12th anniversary in August, and also our 100th show here in Marty's Corner. So we're actually having two celebrations in August here in Marty's Corner. And what we're going to do for the next couple shows is actually bring on guests who have been with us over the years. And our first guest, appropriately, is a resident here of Hacienda Heights who has been with us many times before. Again, she's a friend, a supporter, a person who's given us great advice over the 12 years. And before we bring her out, we want to go and take a quick clip and look at some of the times she's appeared on the show over the last 12 years. So if we can, let's go ahead and roll that clip in the control room. Watch the monitor here, and at home, watch TV.
You know, the psychology of Romper Room was be a doobie. I have a car with a license plate that says doobie.
Yeah!
The robot. Yeah. And the psych, you know what that means? If you're in, I would see all of these little hands waving at me, and I'd say, oh, they're doobies, they're on the inside door. No, if they didn't, they'd say, what's a doobie? I'd say, sorry, you're not in. But, of course, Marty is in, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
Marty, I have your very own doobie sticker.
Oh, bless
Marty.
You.
And it says, I am a Romper Room doobie, but... This means, do you know, Lori, what this means? It means Marty never does anything wrong. He always does what's right. He's a Romper Room doobie all day long. Doobie a bed goer. Don't be a stay upper. Do be a teeth brusher. Don't be a teeth forgetter. Do be a milk drinker. Don't be a milk leaver.
Sure.
Did you eat your veggies?
All the time.
Do be a plate cleaner.
Don't
be
yes.
a food cleaner.
Sure.
And the list goes on and on. And the psychology is to encourage children to really try to do what's right. And if you've got a doobie sticker, it means you always do what. Does he get it, Laurie?
I think Marty deserves it. I do.
Right here?
Yeah. Marty, I'm touched. Oh, Marty, I'm so proud of you.
Can you please give a warm welcome to the former host of Romper Room, Mary Ann King?
Over so many years. They're all grown up, you see, out here.
You know, in fact, a lot of the people we talked to before the show said they actually did grow up watching you for years and years here.
Haven't they turned out well?
They've turned out just great here, actually.
You too!
Oh, well, thank you so much. I remember watching you for years. You were on for about 10 years, I guess, in early television here in L.A. on KCOP Channel 13.
That's right.
That's taking you back, isn't it?
Yes, but it's only time.
It's only time. Real quick before we go to commercial break, what's the first thing you remember about doing the show, or the first time you actually heard of Marty's Corner years ago? What do you remember about it? What was your recollection of Marty's Corner way back then?
You know, I've always loved Marty's Corner, and that's an honest statement. My gosh, we go back a long way, Marty.
We do. I think the first clip we showed was maybe about 8 or 9 years ago.
So. At least, yeah. And I remember that we've always had fun. You've always had a great monologue.
Well, thank you.
And we always have a great audience. You always have great entertainment, great music, great sound. And I remember, it's a good show.
Well, thank
and
you, so
you go all over, which your show truly has really grown to cover a big territory and a big audience now. Starting out at the beginning, it was a growth process.
It sure was. We had nobody watching us for the first couple of years on Marty's Corner, so.
Well, you know.
Thank God.
It's, the word has to spread. I tell everybody, Marty's Corner, Marty's Corner.
Well, we appreciate it. We need to go a quick break, but we'll be back talking more with Mary Ann King. So, Leo, get us out of here, and we'll be right back in 3 minutes, everybody. Marty's Corner Live Saturday night. We're speaking with, of course, Mary Ann King. Mary Ann King from Romper Room. One of the things we want to touch on briefly, if people didn't in the audience know about this, you have a different magic mirror.
Oh, I do. I'm going to have to put some glitter on this because, you know, a little coming out of Hometown Buffet from a big event that I had emceed, and they always asked for the magic mirror, so I put it in my bag, took it in like I did tonight, and did the thing, and then I was walking towards my car, and I heard this roar. I turned to look, and this young man is right here in my face, and that car is whizzing by me at probably 50 miles an hour, and I thought, what? And he reaches down, grabs my bags. And it had my magic mirror in my bag. And the car took me with them for a good bit of distance, and it threw me to the ground and wounded me, and I was laid up for a long time. But I said, just go get my magic mirror. And he said, oh, they're in Chino by now. So I lost my magic mirror. I was out of business. But NBC called me because there was a story in the paper, and they said, Miss Mary Ann, we're going to send a limo to your house. And we're going to pick you up, bring you to NBC Burbank, and then we're going to do a live feed to New York to the Keith Olbermann Show. And if you don't mind, we'll have another guest on the show with you. I said, oh, I don't mind. So I was still not doing well. And they picked me up, took me there, and in the process, he does 5 top stories. This is what's funny. He did 5, 4, 3, 2. I thought, God, he forgot. I'm here on the wrong night. But still, it was fun. He had the makeup and the whole ball of wax. And finally, he said, in our number one story,
Can you believe that, Marty? Miss Marianne and her magic mirror. So I got to say all of those things that happened, and they said, oh, we have a guest for you. In walks this former Romper Room teacher, Sakura, and they found her through Screen Actors Guild, and she said, Miss Marianne, I found my magic mirror in the back of my closet. Haven't touched it in 35 years. I didn't even know I still had it. And she gave it to me. So I'm back in business. NBC for that. Where would you find a plastic mirror? Everything is chrome or lucite, and this is just a good old fashioned. And I'm sure those young hoodlums that stole the mirror thought, "What's this?" And tossed it.
Threw it away. Somebody didn't know what they had in their possession, did they? I'm glad to hear that you've gotten better. Though I know you were kind of on the outs for a little bit.
Yeah, but I was.
You feel pretty good now.
I
mean,
I feel
you look
just great.
Great.
But I want you to know the fire department on Stimson Avenue in Hacienda Heights came up my street. The whole truck and the hazmat unit. And all these wonderful, handsome firemen in their uniforms on an afternoon. And I went out to see what was going on, and they brought me 2 dozen red roses.
Nice.
Yeah, I tell you, everybody was so wonderful. And I do thank them for that. But you know, the magic mirror, even Rosie O'Donnell was upset. I never said her name in my magic mirror. So they called me, flew me to New York so I could say and open her show and say, I see Rosie. And that was fun. I loved it.
You've had a long career, and one of the things in Hacienda Heights you do every year is the July 4th parade, which is coming up, obviously,
absolutely,
on the 4th. Tell us a little bit about the parade real quick.
Well, and you and I have done that together.
We have.
You've
done
all the street. Marty and I have done so many things together. We were reminiscing about all the time and all the events and all the shows we've done, and it's just every time Marty calls, I say, sure, Marty, tell me when and where. And we're a team. And the 4th of July parade is coming up, guess what, on the 4th of July.
Amazing. Isn't that amazing? How they plan that?
I don't know. It's on Monday. Last year it was on July the 5th because we never do the parade on Sunday.
That's right, yeah.
So this year it's on the 4th of July, and we do it live starting at 9 o'clock, and it goes down Stimson Avenue, ending at Stimson Park. It's a wonderful event. And Ken Manning and I have been doing that, I think, now for 17 years,
right.
Where they, Stephanie Edwards and the Bob Eubanks of Hacienda Heights. And it's such a lot of fun to say. And coming down the street is this band, that band, this person, the clowns. It's hometown.
It
and
is.
You've ridden in the parade, Marty.
I've done it a couple
with
of
Marty's
years.
Corner.
We're hoping to do it again this year. So.
I think you should bring all of your fans and friends,
oh,
load
wow.
up a big truck and say, Marty's Corner.
Wow.
And boy, can I tell them who's coming down the street then.
Well, I hope you would.
Yeah, I can.
Can you stay around just a little bit?
I would love to stay
come
around.
Come here for Marianne King. She's going to stay with us the rest of the show. Thank you, sweetheart. Stay right there. Stay right there. We're going to go ahead and do something we do every month here on Marty's Corner, which is, of course, our top 11 list. The top 11 list, which is compiled by our home office in beautiful Baldwin Park. Anybody from Baldwin Park? Wow, we got boos and we got claps. I don't know if that's good or not. We got problems. Well, thank you, Baldwin Park. A lot of us know that just last week, the last Star Wars movie made its premiere. And of course, a lot of the people that work on the show are avid Star Wars fans. So we had to do something on that. So again, we took that, and we're going to have Jody do a drum roll for us in a second here from the band as we bring up the list, which is top 11 signs your neighbor is a Star Wars geek. Okay? Drum roll, please. He refers to his ex as Jabba the Slut. Refers to interracial sex as going to the dark side. Shows up at your Armistice Day party in full Mandalorian battle armor. Number eight. When he's 6, he refers to it as having the Kessel runs. Number 7. His mom drives him to work, but he claims to have a Class B Guggen battle wagon license. What does that mean? I don't know. Geek. Number 6. He knows R2-D2's G-spot, but doesn't know how to remove a girl's bra. Number 5, late at night you can hear him moaning, help me Juan Kenobi, you're my only grope. Number 4, he claims that embarrassing rash is a lightsaber injury. Number 3, his pickup line is, you have caused a disturbance in my pants. Wow. Number 2, refers to alone time behind his computer as Han Solo. Man. And the number 1. He's glued cinnamon rolls to the size of his blow-up doll's head! Wow, that went over well. Okay, now I'm gonna throw right over that way. Good catch.
You're a dopey.
Oh man, bad. We're gonna get some real funny stuff right now for you, ladies and gentlemen. Enough of this insanity. We have a guest that's gonna be making her first appearance here in Marty's Corner. This lady, again, plays all throughout Orange County. Again, she'll be making her first appearance here in Marty's Corner. Can you please give a warm welcome to Mary Kennedy. Mary, come on out, Mary!
Thank you, Marty.
You're welcome.
Hi, everybody. I'm Mary Kennedy, and I'm from Boston, Massachusetts. I am from the East Coast. And the accent is a little bit out of control, just a little. I was watching this documentary on A&E about the 10 biggest murders in Boston, right? And they interviewed the director of psychology at Harvard Medical School, the smartest guy in the world on why people are killing each other, right? Smartest guy. And on national television, he goes, "'Cause they're killers! They're murderers! They're freaking retarded! Red Sox rule!" Yeah, smartest guy in the world, and he sounds like he got off the swordfish boat in a perfect storm. Thank you. That's where I'm from. I love it because my grandma's favorite two words are wicked pissa. So there she is. Love her. She's good. So I'm Irish Catholic. Do we have any Irish Catholics in the audience? Drinking over there early, very early. Yeah, so I'm Irish Catholic, and my favorite times growing up were family funerals. They were. Yeah, the best one was when Uncle Jack, the deceased, was packed in ice with beer bottles around him and a bottle opener on the side of the casket, because nothing says rest in peace like a Bud Light or a keg tap. So there you are. Yeah. So I'm Irish. It's crazy being an Irish girl, I got to tell you. My grandma is turned 89. My grandmother with Alzheimer's turned 89. Let's hear it for her. Come on. That's right. Yep. And she also just found out she's legally blind. True, but the good news is that I got her a gift for her birthday, and when she wasn't looking, I took it back, rewrapped it, and gave it to her for Mother's Day. Won't she be surprised on her next birthday? Thank you. Now, moms, happy Mother's Day. Give yourselves a big round of applause. Come on. That's right, that's right. My mother is so supportive. She really, really is. I was in a depression recently, and she goes, "Snap out of it. Your depression is making me depressed." Oh, gee. Oh, God. All right. Bipolar benefit next week, people. Come on in. So that's mom. Yeah, my mother, right, when my parents got divorced, she started a band. She did, to support us kids, which consisted of 40-year-old divorcees singing Hot Stuff and Locomotion called the Mood Swings. Now that they're in their 60s, they're called the Hot Flashes. You know, it's crazy, I gotta say, being in my family, I gotta be honest. And, you know, the strangest thing is that my mother is always on my case to have a baby, really, she is. Listen to this, but the only thing I have is this lovely post-pregnancy pouch. Look at it, isn't it delicious? Look, look, look. And I've never had a baby, okay? Never. I was teaching kindergarten, and this five-year-old came up to me and went, "Baby, baby." And I said, "No, burrito, burrito." It's all about educating the young. That's what I said. Yeah. Really, truly. Isn't that, it's gorgeous, really. I'm Angelina Jolie right here. Anyway, so here's the thing, though. I got to be honest. I have just become an aunt. I have. Let's hear it for me. Come on. Yeah, 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 yeah. My good-looking brother, okay, married an ex-pro cheerleader from Oklahoma, and they combined to create the most hideous child ever imaginable. My niece, Madison Brooke Kennedy, a.k.a. Manhead, okay? Now, here's the thing. When you have an ugly baby, do not put the baby on a holiday card. Don't. Do I need to be reminded at the happiest and holiest time of the year that I've got a freaking mutant alien of a niece? True. And another thing is, do not accessorize the ugly baby. Don't. Okay, she had Liberace rings on every fat finger, okay? She had a wrapper chain around her little baby neck with her initial N. And to top it off, they gave her a satin bow on her bald head. She didn't look like a baby. She looked like Vin Diesel in drag. Speaking of drag, I gotta be honest, dating in LA is tough. I got it, ladies, you know what I'm talking about, right? Right? The square dancers do. It's really tough. I gotta be honest. I just do, really. You know why? Because I date the gay man. I do. I do. I date the gay man. I've turned four men gay. Four. Four. Count them. Four. Square dancers, watch out. Only four. Yeah, you're my fifth. Anyway, so here's the thing. kidding. But here's the thing. You know, sex with a gay man isn't that bad, ladies and gentlemen. It really isn't. You got great sheets, good lighting, ABBA playing in the background. Take a chance on me. Woo! Yeah, the problem was he never took a chance. There you are. Speaking of, because of that, I'm always the bridesmaid. I've been in 12 weddings, everybody. 12. 12. And the worst thing about being in the wedding, being the bridesmaid, is the bride. I mean, let's just be honest. And the thing that she makes you wear, okay, in the last wedding I was in, she made me wear the Zum Zum dress. Okay, for you guys that don't know what it is, it's a puffy green, lime green dress, okay? And it's made of acrylic fiber, so if you're in a candlelight ceremony, you'll be a fire hazard. Yeah. But the best part, laugh louder so they can hear you. But the best part of the dress is that when they zip it up the back, the fat from your back comes over the top of the dress. That's right, Marty. So when you're walking down the aisle, you look like you're wearing a cape. A cape of bacon flapping in the wind, ladies and gentlemen. That's my time. Thank you so much. Good night.
Come on. This is Marianne King. Marianne, have a seat right here. Have a seat right here.
Gorgeous.
Mary, Marianne, Marianne, Mary, Mary, Marty, Marty, Marianne, Marianne, Marty, Marianne, Mary, Marty, Mary. Had to do that one. Had to do that one.
Okay.
Now you're a Kennedy from Massachusetts. Are you related to the Kennedys?
I am.
You are related to the Kennedys.
Yes, I am.
You
yes.
are really.
Yes, second cousins twice removed.
Does that mean you're a Democrat?
That means I'm white trash Kennedy.
Oh,
that's
yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
Now, do you have any
I'm a Democrat.
Do you have any stories about your family members? Like Teddy? Any Teddy stories?
Uncle Ted?
Uncle Ted, sure.
I am so close to Uncle Ted that when his office gave me a scholarship for college, he sent his representative to meet with my father and I. Yeah, we're not close.
Wow.
Not close. We're the poor white trash. We're Kmart Kennedy, if you will. That's me.
So how are you related? Which way?
JFK's grandfather and my great-great-grandfather are brothers.
Okay.
Still, though, that's
good,
it's more than I can say.
Yeah. That's great. You have some shows coming up. What do you got going on lately?
I will be up in Sunnyvale at Rooster Tea Feathers for a week on August 18th through the 21st. And that's about it for now.
If people want to get a hold of you, do you have a website or something they can actually log on to? What website is that?
www.maryekennedy.com.
Can we have Mary Kennedy here? Stay right here, Mary.
Thank you so much.
We hope you ladies like square dancing because I'm going to make a fool of myself right now. We have a group of individuals that, again, have been nice enough to come down on a Saturday night. And before I bring them out to do some performing for us, we're going to bring out the head of this dance group. And so can you please give a warm welcome to Bill from the Funsters. Bill, come on out. Bill! Come on here. Let me get a microphone here if I can. It's not coming out of there. This is not where. There it is, right there. Real quick, Bill, what are the Funsters?
The Funsters is a square dance club, and I pretty well says it. We're a square dance club. We get together every month and have a square dance. It's America's national dance, national folk dance.
You were saying that it's actually the official dance of America. How did that happen? How do you become official, you know, dance of America?
Back in the Reagan years, the Congress, somebody put up a motion to pass a bill to make folk square dancing the national folk dance.
How long have you been dancing now?
I've been dancing for about 9 years.
Primarily in this group here?
Yeah. I started off with a club called Levi's and Lace, and then I later joined the Funster Square Dance Club.
And where are you guys out of? Where are you guys located at?
City of Covina.
City of Covina. Real close to us right here. Yeah,
yeah, we're real close.
Now, you have again, all kinds of ages that are dancing square.
Yeah, we do. We have some youth dancers that are with us. They also belong to a club down in Orange County called the Croakers.
The Croakers?
The Croakers, yeah. Their mascot is a frog. Ours is a clown. Yeah, theirs is a frog.
Freddie Funster, is that
Freddie
right?
Freddie Funster, yeah.
And Freddie Funster is about this big or something like this? He's a big old clown?
This tall. He's dressed out in clown outfit. He's homemade by several of the club members got together and made him about 16 years ago they made him.
Yeah.
And he's been our mascot ever since. Now, our club's about 50 years old.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, it was started in 1954.
Wow.
And it's been around all that time. Thank you. Thank you.
Now, again, I didn't know anything about square dancing before we contacted you folks, and we're going to go ahead and bring out first the caller, who I guess is integral to the actual dancing, correct?
Yeah, it's kind of it's real necessary. Kind of hard to do it without it.
I guess let's bring out Dale first. Dale, come on out. Dale Hopper. Dale, there you go. Dale, send him on to me. Now, what's your job as the caller?
I am the caller, and I am the entertainer of the bunch. I sing.
Wow.
I tell them what to do. They don't always do what I tell them, but I'm the entertainer. I put on the show.
We okay. never let a caller tell us what to do.
That's good for you.
All right, so, Dale, why don't you get into a place where you need to be? Do you need this microphone, Dale?
I certainly do.
Take that away from me. All right, let's
Can
go.
Can I tell a few jokes?
No. No, not enough. Let's go and bring out the dancers. Come on out. Come on out, everybody. Come on. Here we go. Why don't you get into your places here? Now, what are we going to be doing now, Dale? What is this we're going to be doing right now?
We're going to be doing some of our national folk dance. Square dancing. Modern American square dancing. All right?
Okay, go to it. Take
Maestro,
it away.
Please. Don't be nervous, Funsters. This is fun. Here we go. All right, here we go. Circle to the left. How does she know what makes me laugh? Do an Alaman lift for the corner. Don't sado your bow. Do an Alaman lift for the corner again and weave the ring. How does she figure me out so easily? Swing and promenade. Well, I swear that girl's been spying on me. Heads square through four. Away, swing through, boyer and right, you bend the line and a right and left through, turn the girl, flutter wheel, hot dog, star through, swing your corner, promenade. Well, I swear, that girl, she been spying on me. Head couples, star through, pass through, don't sado your corner. Make a way. Swing through. Boyer under the right and then couples circulate. You chain down the line and turn the girl, boys. Square through. Go three-quarter round. That corner swing. Promenade. Well, I know that pretty girl, she been spying on me. Sides face. Grand square. Now she been using information I had locked up deep inside. To be the perfect woman, I'm a man left with a corner. Now weave the ring. I'll weave it in and out, boys. Till you meet your pretty little girl. When you do, you swing her. Promenade. Now I know that girl's been spying on me. Sides, touch a quarter. Boy, run around a girl. Make a wave, swing through. Boy, run around a girl, bend the line. Do the right and left through, turn the girl. Now pass the ocean, please. Recycle. Swing your corner, girl. Take her by the hand. You promenade, you see. Well, I swear, that girl's been sides. Square through four. Forehand sides. Do-sado that corner, girl. Make a wave. Swing through. Boy, run around a girl. Ferris what? Very good. Centers pass through. Touch a quarter. Scoot back, go boys. Scoot back, girls. You swing and promenade. You were what I swear. That pretty girl, she been spying on me. Join hands, circle to the left, go round, circle to the left. Everybody into the middle with a great big yee-haw. Circle to the left, go round, now. Alaman lift with the old left hand. Partner right, do the right and left grand. Grand right and left. Go moving round, swing your honey. Promenade. Well, I know, Alaman left that corner. She been spying on me, bow to the partner. Out of the corner. Go back to stack the wood with a partner. All right. Good dancing. Hey, where's Marty?
Excuse me. All right.
All right.
Come on. All right. Come on. Let's do this. Okay, so what you're gonna show me is kind of the basics of square dancing, correct?
No, these are the advanced lessons that we're giving you now.
Oh. Right? Yeah. Well, I got my head on. Now, do I have to make noises like Bill was making
Absolutely.
When I do this?
Oh, yeah.
You have to make whoops and hoo and all that kind
all right.
of stuff?
Well, now, listen, Marty. Your partner is on your right, and your corner is on your left.
All right. Marty's corner or just the corner?
Just the corner.
All
that's
right.
That's
right. A tie-in right there.
Now, listen. You're one of the head couples. The couples are the head couples are the ones that have their backs to the stage and that are facing the stage. That means you're in charge, Marty.
We're in trouble.
All right.
Okay.
And the sides are the ones that are facing
like
the sides of the square.
This is an accident waiting to happen with these people turning around. I'm going to nail somebody. I just know. Okay. I apologize for anybody's feet I step
all
on.
All right. Now, be a doobie, all right?
All right, fine. Okay. Wow. Okay.
Everybody face your corner. Face your corner. And take a left forearm grip. This is called the famous Alaman left, Marty.
Okay.
Do an Alaman left with your corner. Now, Whoa. Here's your partner. You're facing your partner. We're going to do a do-si-do. Now, the way we do that is we pass our partner with a right shoulder.
Okay.
We take a step to the right and back up, passing with our left shoulder. That's a do-si-do. Once again, face your corner. Do an Alaman left with a corner. And a do-si-do your own.
Whoa.
All the way around there.
Here we go.
Here we go. Back to your corner. Do an Alaman left with a corner. And stop once again facing your partner.
All the way around?
All the way around.
All right.
Now shake right hands with your partner and say, you're the best partner I've had all day
long.
All right. Very good. We're going to do a right and left grand. Now the way we do that is we pull by the right. Then with the next one we run into, we pull by the left and by the right and so on and so forth till we meet our partner again. Girls, turn around. Get into that promenade position, that skater's promenade, and promenade till you get back home. Promenade home. That is called promenade. Hey, very good. Let's give him a hand, everybody.
All right. Let's fire up some music so I can understand what you're doing.
Here we go.
Here we go.
Bow to the partner. Bow to the corner. Join hands. Circle to the left.
Oh.
Circle to the left. Go around. Circle to the left. Circle to the left. Now!
Woohoo! All right.
Alaman left with a corner.
Oh, yeah. That's right.
Don't side-o your partner.
Oh.
Do an Alaman left with a corner.
Oh, here we go.
Do the right and left grand. Right pull by. Here we left go. Pull by. Right pull by. Left pull by.
And run this way. Oh!
Promenade.
Here we go.
I'm holding up my point of
Woo!
View. Heads. Pass through. Separate. Go home. Right shoulder, Marty, right shoulder.
Right shoulder, okay.
Sides, you pass through. Separate, go on home. Everybody face your partner. Do a do-sa-do with the partner. Over to the corner, do an Alaman lift with the corner.
Whoa,
do the right lift grand, all the way around
here. I'm getting thrown around here.
Promenade. I'm honing up my Whoa. Point of view. I got a new attitude. Heads, pass through. Separate, go on home. Sides, you pass through. Separate, go on home. Everybody face your partner. Do the right and left grand. Right pull by, left pull by, right pull
Woo!
By, left pull by. Swing your partner, swinger.
Swinger.
Swing your partner. Promenade that frame. Join hands, circle to the left.
Circle to the
circle
left.
To the left. Now circle to the right.
Oh, man.
To the left.
Hey, wait a
to the
second.
Right.
Oh, come
to the
on.
Left. Circle to the left, go round, circle to the left. Alaman left with a corner.
Alaman to the left of the corner.
Do the right left, grand.
Left leg, there left. You go.
Go moving around the ring.
Wow.
Promenade. I'm feeling good from my head to my shoe.
Real quick, if anyone wants to get a hold of this group, what's the best way to get a hold of them, Dale?
The best way to get a hold of them is on the internet. You can get it from docido.com, or you can call
4funsters.com.
Okay.
We have a website of our own. Or you can call me direct at 909-941-7895.
And then people are square dancing all across America as we speak tonight. Is that right?
All across America, all around the world.
In fact, tell us about, around the world, if people are square dancing, what language are they using?
English.
It's only English?
Only English. Wherever you go, they teach it in English.
So if you have somebody from Korea doing it, they're doing it in English as they're making the calls?
Well, as close as they get to English.
Oh, I understand. Okay. So again, we want to thank the Funsters for coming down here on a Saturday
right.
night.
Thank you,
Bill. We need to go away for a 3-minute break. We'll be right back. Don't go away. Leo, get us out of here. Saturday night here at Marty's Corner. As I mentioned at the beginning of the show, these ladies have been with us one time before. They're going to be making their second appearance. They just released their current CD, which is Ugly in Mono. Can you please give a warm welcome to Pretty in Stereo? Yeah! Pretty in Stereo. Real quick, can you introduce the folks behind you first on bass guitar to our right?
Bass guitar is Lynn.
Lynn over on bass guitar, ladies and gentlemen. And to your left on guitar?
That's Christine.
Christine over here. And of course, back on the drums?
Jody Joy.
Jody, thank you. Thank you for the top 11. Appreciate it, Jody. Yeah, new CD just came out. When was the actual launch on that?
Actually, that was about February, March.
So it's been a couple months now?
Yeah.
And since you've been on the show, you guys have really taken off. You have something special coming up. What do you have coming up?
Actually, we're playing Warped Tour July 1st in Long Beach. That's a big thing for us. We'll be on the Shira Girl stage. So if you're going, check us out.
you've also got some other exposure. You said you've been on TV or something?
We've actually had our songs featured in a few. There was an American Idol documentary that they did for a former contestant. And we also have been getting some radio play on 103.9 FM.
Yes.
In the Inland Empire. So we've actually been getting some good media exposure.
You're playing a lot of gigs. You played a really nice place last night. Where'd you play last night?
We played Angels Sports Bar.
And tell us about Angels.
Angels is a great place. There's a ladies, or actually gentlemen's lounge. Yeah. Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen's lounge, I guess, because both people like to go there.
Yeah.
I guess. So it's actually a pretty neat place. So.
Right next door?
Right next door.
You had a hard time getting in last night, didn't you?
Yeah.
Heard all about that. Again, you've been playing. What's the plan? What's the goal here of Pretty in Stereo?
Well, we're just going to be playing our butts off and trying to get as tight as we can. And we want a tour. We'd really like to do that by next summer. We'd like to be on tour and have a full length that we're backing. So
we're still glad you guys decided to come back.
Thanks for having us.
No, we love to have you come down. You're going to be doing one more song. Is this from the CD?
No, this will be on our full length that we're going to be releasing
something new
next year. Yes.
Something new. What song is this called?
This is called Love is Red.
Ladies and gentlemen, one more time. Pretty in Stereo. Take it away, Natalie. Let's go. We do need to get out of here for a Saturday night. We're running short on time, so we want to go ahead and first of all thank all of our guests for showing up here at Marty's Corner. First, of course, Mary Ann King from Romper Room. Mary Ann, thank you so much. And of course, Mary Kennedy. Mary, thank you so much for coming down. Say hello to Ted when you see him for me, could you please? And of course, Bill and Dale from the Funsters who made it down tonight. Thank you for coming down and having me make a fool of myself. And of course, we're going to see you next month on Marty's Corner. And as we go out, we want the ladies from Pretty in Stereo to do one more song for us. Again, Pretty in Stereo, their new CD. Make sure you get this CD. It's a great, great CD. Take care, Marty's Corner. Take care. Guys, play us out. Pretty in Stereo, anything you want. Go! You know how it is.
take a break.